Terrence Crawford laughs at Errol Spence calling himself the big fish when he ain't fought himself. And he calls himself a killer whale orca. We're going to get into all this. Stay tuned. What up, Fight World? It's your boy, Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to my channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chats channel donations, the Venmo donations, the Cash App, which is $BoxingEgo, and the Patreon family. We work. Sign up for ESPN Plus below using my link. It does help the channel continue to grow, pump out content like this. ESPN Plus, they got a ton of original content, docuseries, documentaries, archive footage of boxing and UFC fights, including Teofimo Lopez versus Lomachenko fight can be found right there. ESPN Plus as a standalone app is $5.99 a month. If you want more content, you can get the ESPN Plus, Hulu, and Disney Plus bundle. All three of those apps for one price, a low price of $12.99. Now, let's get it. Terrence Crawford, he laughs at the notion from Errol Spence that he's the big fish, you know, in the ocean. This is what Crawford said in a recent interview. Quote, when Errol Spence calls himself the big fish, I just laugh, you know, because you can't be the big fish if you ain't fought the orca yet. So he said he a killer whale. A lot of people will say, oh, he's bigger than me, he's stronger than me. How you know? I get a real kick out of it because I know me and I know what I'm capable of doing and I know what I'm going to do. That's why I don't feed into everybody commenting on social media posts. Oh, you running from Spence, you running from this guy, or you running from that guy. It's always going to be an excuse. Errol Spence got in a car accident. That's going to be an excuse, or he was never the same fighter. I never wanted to fight somebody coming off an injury like that. For what? To set myself up for failure? So now y'all can say, oh, this is the reason. I want you at your best. I want you to feel you're at your best because I respect you as a man. I want you to look me in my eyes and say, I'm ready. I'm 110% ready, and we're going to do this. Let's make it work. That's an end quote from Terrence Bud Crawford. Now, you know, I like Crawford's attitude overall. Like, he's definitely a true competitor. You see, he's getting ready for the Kell Brook fight, somebody that Errol Spence beat a couple years ago by stoppage. So we'll see how Terrence Crawford does. You know, I don't have too many comments on this statement from Crawford. He did do an interview with Brian Custer, and I made a video about it. Check that video on the channel. I dropped it yesterday, and I'll put the link in the description. You guys need to take a listen to that video because he revealed some interesting things where he said, you know, his future and what his future holds, that he could possibly fight on PBC, which is what a lot of people have been requesting out of him. I don't know if it's a campaign to build hype for the Kell Brook fight, or if he's serious and maybe limited his time there with Top Rank. But I feel like at his age, people know how good he's at, like how good he is, but he has to get the big names that people want to see him fight somehow, some way. So if that means going to PBC or, you know, storming into the Top Rank offices, it is what it is. You gotta do something because he's too talented. And I'm going to continue to say that, you know, certain guys in boxing are too talented to sit on the shelf, too talented to not fight contemporaries and people that are in their age group and in their skill level of their skill bracket, you know. And Crawford is one of them. Demetrius Andrade, you know, different guys like that who they're around the same age. And They fought solid names. But what Crawford needs is not only a solid, like, skilled fighter, but somebody with the brain, the brand name recognition that people will all know and respect. And I told you for years, it made no sense for Top Rank to not have given him Pacquiao and to give that fight to a school teacher and Jeff Horn. And first of all, I don't even think Jeff Horn beat Pacquiao for real. And that's who they gave the fight to. When Crawford was in the queue and in line, and that clearly should have happened. Bomac and Crawford both said they were down to fight Pacquiao, and Top Rank didn't make that happen. Now, there's an interview on the internet with Cameron Duncan, who worked heavily with Top Rank, and he revealed something that was shocking to some, that he said the Top Rank matchmaker has an NBF list, which stands for No Black Fighters, meaning if there was a certain guy that they didn't want his chances of losing to increase or whatever, they would not put him in with black fighters and just not give him the opportunity, which sounds very consistent with what I've told you for years about the matchmaking and how Lomachenko per se is match different than black fighters that Top Ranks has. I've said this for years before that interview even came out. You know, Crawford, again, he's fought some guys that should be able to rival him and or beat him, but it's his own ability and skill, which is why he didn't lose to them guys. Like Victor Postol, Terrence Crawford fought him at the height of his career, coming off the Lucas Matisse win, you know, and he was bigger than Crawford. It just so happens Crawford's that good, and he made him look easy. But years later, a champion in Jose Ramirez fights the same guy, but after Crawford beat him, after Josh Taylor beat him, and Jose Ramirez, you know, if we're being honest, he didn't look sensational in that fight. And some people even had Postol winning or had the fight a draw. But Crawford, people didn't want to give him credit for that. You know what I mean? So Crawford, he's fought guys, Felix Diaz's, and you know, people, if you don't fight them right, they could beat you. Mean Machine, stuff like that. So he's beyond that. He needs a person who could rival his skill set, but also carries a big name, you know, like Errol Spence is about to fight Danny Garcia. Terrence Crawford is just now fighting somebody that Errol Spence already beat. So when it comes to Crawford, Errol Spence, I don't really see it happening unless he somehow busts a move to Top Rank. And you see how fake the ESPN pound for pound list is. The ESPN pound for pound list, for years, they forced Lomachenko down your throat, Chocolatito, and they put all these other people and other fighters with, you know, some who weren't even with ESPN, like Chocolatito, in the number one spot. And they refuse to allow this man who's highly skilled. And while Lomachenko and Chocolatito had lost, they lost at this point. To this point, Terrence Crawford hasn't lost. And it took for Lomachenko to give up the first seven rounds and lose embarrassingly in a humiliating fashion for them to realize that Terrence Crawford should have been ranked higher than Lomachenko. And it's sad. Teddy Atlas himself, when he was working with the network, told Andre Ward, who did this interview with Terrence Crawford, and Terrence Crawford, that they both need to take a seat behind Lomachenko's greatness, and Lomachenko, with eight fights and the loss, is better. So it tells you the type of program that they're on, you know, and what type of time they're on. You know, Crawford's been dope. See, and it's funny. ESPN refused to put Terrence Crawford at number one until Lomachenko lost, right? But ESPN and similar, like, you know, old media fans, they keep begging for Crawford to fight against Errol Spence, who is the other best guy at welterweight. You know, Errol Spence is the one number one guy at welterweight, and that's who they want Crawford to fight. But Lomachenko could have fought Mikey Garcia, and they didn't want fights like that. They never pushed for it like they're pushing for Crawford and Errol Spence, because it's black on black crime. It's two African-American fighters fighting each other. So it's like, some of these racists and old media, they don't really care. They just want to see a good fight. They don't care who they all. It's the lesser of two evils. At the end of the day, Crawford or Spence got to lose, and they're good with that. But when it comes to Lomachenko and Mikey Garcia, you know, they don't want to see that, and they don't want to push for that and advocate for that. And that can't be the narrative, because they know Mikey Garcia could potentially put Lomachenko's lights out or beat him, right? That's why they're making this back door for Lomachenko after he looked pretty bad, in my opinion, versus Teofimo, based on who he was supposed to be. He didn't look like no pound for pound number one. He didn't. You can say whatever you want, but he didn't look pound for pound number one to me. And now they're trying to give him the scapegoat, say his shoulder hurt, or he's really a 126 pounder. He needs to move back down to 130. But they want Crawford, an African American fighter, to fight the number one welterweight with another network. But they didn't want to give even Teofimo the opportunity at Lomachenko when Teofimo first started calling them out. So you see the double standards there. But back to Crawford Spence, I'm sparing how much I talk about this subject, because it's the same stuff. It's like, oh, I want to fight him, you know. So I got to mix the videos up, and they got to show me something. And I think only way that fight happens is if Crawford likely were to go to PBC. That's the only thing that I could really see, and the only way I could see it happening. Until then, it's just really a pipe dream, because Bob Arum keeps saying stuff like, oh, we want to give Crawford Pacquiao and Qatar and Dubai and all this stuff, but it never happens. So the time is ticking for Crawford to get those meaningful fights and meaningful names. We'll see what happens. Let me know what you guys think. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. As always, hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego, signing off.
So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.